सो द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक राइट डाउन रिलेशनशिप क्वेरीज. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट रिलेशनशिप क्वेरीज राइट. सो देर इज ऑब्जेक्ट वन एंड देन देर इज ऑब्जेक्ट टू राइट. सो यू वॉन्ट टू राइट डाउन अ क्वेरी इन विच यू गेट द रिकॉर्ड्स ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट वन एज वेल एज द रिकॉर्ड्स विच आर रिलेटेड टू द रिकॉर्ड्स ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट टू विच आर रिलेटेड टू द रिकॉर्ड्स विच यू गॉट फ्रॉम ऑब्जेक्ट वन. So what I mean by that is imagine account and contact. There is a one-to-many relationship over there. Now what you want to do is you want to query some account records, but with those account records you want their contacts as well. So like there are 100 account records as a whole in that particular object, in the account object. You want 20 account you want only 20 account records, but with those 20 account records you want the associated contacts to come as well. So in this case, how are you going to write down the query? That is what we are going to understand in relationship query. Is it clear? It's the opposite way as well. It's the other way around as well. Let me explain it to you. So if you're querying the records on contact, you want the information of the associated account as well. So if you're writing a query which will return 30 contact records, you want the name of the account with which they are associated. You want the number of employees of the account with which these contacts are associated. How are you going to get that? That is what you're going to understand in relationship query. Is it clear? Okay, cool. Let's go. So there are two types of relationship queries, right? Number one, child to parent. So in this case, which one is child, which one is parent? Contact is child and account is parent. So child to parent basically means that you are writing the query on contact object, right? And by the way, from and over here we write down the object name. Select the name from, after we write down the object name. So if we are writing down contact after from and we want the information of associated account, then in that case this is a child to parent. And if we are writing down from account and we want associated contacts with it, then this is parent to child. That's what it is. Sorry. So how to identify on which object the query is getting fired? Whichever object comes after from, right? That's the object on which the query gets fired. So that's what it is from account, from contact. Now let's go back and discuss how the child to parent relationship queries work. So let me give you a situation. What I want is I want some contact object records, and with those contact object records, I want the name of the account with which they are associated as well as the number of employees fields value with the account with which they are associated. So how I'm going to write down the query? Have a look. And any idea how we're going to write down the query? Okay, so there is no join in SOQL. There's no join in SOQL. Tell me how we're going to write it down. Object one comma. After from, we cannot write down two table names or two object names. We can only write down one. And S object, it's the return type of that. So that's what exactly is join. But we cannot use join because there is no join in Apex or SOQL. Exactly, using the dot notation. Let me explain it to you how it works. So you're writing down a query like this, right? This is a standard object, contact. Contact, con list, select first name, last name. So these are the fields of contact object. Then account dot name and account dot number of employees from contact. So listen, right? What we are doing over here. Here this account is the parent object reference, which is relationship fields name on child object. So whenever we want to create a relationship like this, object one and object two, Like what do we need to do in if you want to create a relationship like this? What do we need to do in order to create a relationship like this? On many side objects. So we'll create a relationship field over here on object 2. And when we create that relationship field, we give it a name as well. Yes or no? We do? So, okay. When we create a relationship field on object 2, which will be related to object 1, we give a particular name to that to that field. Automatically, by default, there is a name. If we choose that, then it's okay. But we can give another name as well. So, like, imagine we are creating a relationship between student and rating. So, like, it's our choice. I mean, if we want to leave it as student ID only, or if you want to, make it as rating for this student. If we'll make it as rating for this student, then in that case, the fields label and the fields API name will be rating for this student. And which field I'm talking about? Relationship field. So over here, account is a like relationship field. Account is a standard object, and the relationship between account and contact is predefined, so we cannot change that API name. So the API name of the field which is there on contact object is account only. And let me explain it to you. I mean, there's a lot of confusion that might get involved with this, but you need to clear it out right now, because otherwise later you might face some problems. So we'll go to contact and fields and relationships. See the field name. Right, it can be something else as well. So if it is something else, then you'll, instead of using account in here, you'll have to use the fields API name, the relationship fields API name, instead of the object name. You might be thinking that we have just written down the object name. No, we haven't written the object name. What we have written over here is the relationship fields name. That's what it is, right? So if this relationship field name would have been which contact, which account this contact belongs to, something like that, which account, then in that case, instead of account dot number of employees, I would have written which underscore contact dot number of employees, or which underscore account dot number of employees, or dot name, something similar to that. Is it clear? So whenever we want to go from child to parent, all what we have to do is take the help from the relationship field to traverse to the See, look over here. Whenever we want to get any field's value from many side object or from child object to the parent object, then in that case, we use the reference of the relationship field. We traverse to the one side object, and then we, with the help of dot operator, then we just write down the field name which we want to access in that situation. That's all what it is, right? So whenever you want to do child to parent relationship, or whenever you want to make a child to parent relationship query, this is how you're going to do that. First, write down the field names for the object on which you're writing the query. And then later for the parent one, you'll have to write it down like this, where the first thing that is coming up is the relationship field's name. And after that, you can just write down the field name for the field which you want to access from the parent object. Is it clear, everyone? So this one is child. Obviously, account and contact has got a relationship of one to many, where contact is the child and account is parent. So we are writing the query on the child object, and we are getting the field values from the parent object. That's all what we are doing. Opportunity, something, some field. So it needs to be the parent of contact. If it has a direct relationship of one to many with contact, where contact is onto the many side, then you can just write down its name and it will work. So it will work onto one to many. Because everywhere there is one to many relationship only if there is a relationship. Even on many to many relationship, there are two one to many relationship with the junction. You got it, Abhishek? Well, let me explain it to you once again. No, account in account.name, account is not the parent object's name. It is the relationship field's name which is created onto the contact object in order to establish that relationship. So there is this account and there is this contact. And this relationship field, like this relationship can only be possible when we create a relationship field. And the name of that relationship field is also account, fortunately, in here. But if the relationship field name would have been something else, then instead of account.name, we would have used something else. Like, let's say the name of the relationship field is related to contact. Related to account, sorry. Related to account. Then in that case, instead of writing down account.name, I would have written down related to account.name. That's what I'm saying. I hope it is clear. Let's talk about how it's gonna work with standard objects or with custom objects, and then you'll probably understand. And even after that, if you'll not understand, we'll explain it once again. Okay, let's go to the next custom object. So there is a relationship between student and rating object, right? Over here, I've written down the query like select name, rating for _ C. So this field is present on rating object, right? Rating out of 10, this field is also present on rating object. And then comes student_r.name. student_r.studentemail_. See, let's talk about it. Let's go to our object manager. And to have a relationship like this, where the relationship field would have been created? Child, which is child? Rating. So let's go to the rating object. And onto the rating object, let's go to the fields and relationships. And over here, there is a master detail relationship with student. Click onto it. And see, student_ C, this is the API name, like student, right? That's the field name. If I'm gonna edit it, so if it is the field name, that's exactly what we are using in here. student_r. So whenever we want to traverse from one object to another with the help of relationship field, and if it is a custom relationship field, then we'll have to append _r at the end of it, right? So similar to if it is a custom object or if it is a custom field, we have to add _c. If it is a custom relationship, then we have to add _r, right? And after adding _r, we can just write down the field name that you want to access. But what if I change this? Instead of student, let me make it I made the name as student who got the rating, and let me save it. It'll give an error. I cannot save it like this because I'm using it in a trigger. I'm using it in here, SQL class 6. Let me save it again. Why? Okay, the name got changed. Student who got the rating. That's the relationship field's name. Now let me uncomment this and I think I uncommented the other one. This is right. This is what it is. Student underscore underscore r dot name. Let me save this. Error. Let's see what the error is. Rating for rating out of 10. Error. Didn't understand. See this. Didn't understand relationship. Student underscore underscore R in the field path. If you are attempting to use a custom field, be sure to append this and that. So like the object name is still student. But I'm not able to access the field of that particular object. Why? Because the relationship field name is different. What is the relationship field name? Student who got the rating. So I'll write down student who got the rating underscore underscore R over here and over here as well. And let me save it. Let's see if the problem goes. Is it gone? So that's exactly what I'm trying to explain. Now Abhishek and Disha, tell me if you're able to understand it. Disha, cool. Abhishek. Perfect. Yes, that's what it is. So, I mean, instead of the writing down the object name, you'll have to write down the relationship field's name, appending it with an underscore underscore R if it is a custom relationship field. That's all. I hope it is clear. Now, if I'll just change it again so that we do not get confused. Now it's back to student, and if I'll uncomment this, there's an error. Why? Because there's nothing like student who got the rating. There's only student underscore underscore R and student underscore underscore R. That's all. Why? Select name from. So name is a standard field on every object. So when you create rating, there is a rating ID which gets associated to every rating. See name. On every object there is a name field. The rating ID of rating. Or I mean if it would have been name, then we would have got rating name instead of student's name, because student name is stored in different field. So when we are writing down the query, whatever fields we write down over here are from the object which is written after from. So over here with name, have you written down any object name or any relationship field name? So it is gonna get the name from rating object. So this rating ID, when we created this rating object, we created the first field as rating ID, which is an auto number. And the API name of the first field that you create with a custom object is always name. So that is the field that we are querying over there. Is it clear, everyone? So this will return the rating ID. This will return for assignment of like whether you have given this rating for assignment, whether you have given this rating for test, whether you have given this rating for what. And then rating out of 10, it is going to give you that number which you have given, and then the student name. This student name is not going to include the name. What it's going to include? Student ID. Because again, on student also, we specified the first field as ID, auto number, right? And then there was student underscore underscore r dot student email. That's a custom field that we've created over there. I hope it is clear. Everyone? So that's how your child to parent relationship queries work. So do you have document file or printed notes for SQL? Yeah, I mean, I'm going to post it once I'm done with all of this. Okay, with this, we are done with child to parent relationship. All what you have to take care of is that instead of writing down the object name, we'll write down the relationship field name, and if it is a custom relationship field name, then append address underscore r. Write it down if you want to. I mean, like, just write down. While writing a child to parent relationship query, we just have to write down the field name. We just have to write down the field name of the relationship field. We just have to write down the field name of the relationship field with the help of which we have created that relationship. In order to traverse to the parent object, we have to write down the field name instead of add over there. We have to write down the field name instead of the object name. वहीं पे जहाँ लिखा है ना, arrow लगा के ऊपर लिख दो. We have to write down the field name, or you can write down, we have to write down the field relationship name instead of the object name in order to traverse to the parent object. Ab niche ek aur point likho. If the relationship is custom, then we have to append underscore underscore r at the end of it.
Okay.
So that's how the child to parent relationship queries work, right?